story time on how I caught my mom sleeping with her sister's husband, her brother-in-law. And this is a continuation of the story time where my mom married my boyfriend. Okay, so boom. After my mom divorced my boyfriend for treating her horribly, trying to get back with me and cheating on her religiously, my mom got very depressed because me or my dad was not talking to her. Only person that was there for her was her sister, which is my aunt. My auntie had the biggest heart in the world. She was very forgiving. So even after my mom did what she did, my auntie still tried to play peacemaker. She tried to make me and my mom squash everything, but that wasn't about to happen because my mom slept, got pregnant, and married my boyfriend. I'm not forgiving anything. So because my mom was so sad and lonely, my auntie was going over there a lot more than usual just to be her support system. So of course, because my auntie was spending so much time there, her husband ended up helping my mom a lot too. And that was a big mistake. Like for part two. Part two on how I caught my mom sleeping with her sister's husband, her brother-in-law. And this is a continuation of the story time where my mom slept with my boyfriend. So like I said, my auntie had a big heart and was spending a lot of time with my mom because my mom had no one else. And since my auntie was spending a lot of time there, so was her husband. But there were times where my auntie couldn't see my mom because she was at work. So she sent her husband to just do a quick checkup and give her some of the food that my auntie cooked. For some reason, my auntie still trusted my mom, which is her little sister. I don't know why, but she did. Well, one day while my auntie was at work, my mom called her saying she was having a breakdown. So my auntie sent her husband to check on her and give her some food. But in actuality, what was really happening is that when my auntie went to work, my mom would call and fake like she's having a breakdown and she needs help, just so my auntie would send her husband to the rescue and so that it wouldn't look suspicious while he was there. Well, their little sick plan didn't work this time. Like for part three. Part three on how I caught my mom sleeping with her sister's husband, her brother-in-law. And this is a continuation of the story time where my mom slept with my boyfriend. Like I said, my mom called my auntie acting like she was having a nervous breakdown, so my auntie sent her husband to check on her. But what they didn't know is that my auntie called me. My auntie basically called me because she really felt bad for my mom. She kept telling me to go check on her to make sure she's okay because she's going through a lot right now. She says she know what my mom did was wrong, but that I only have one mom, and if God forbid something happened, I wouldn't regret not talking to my mom. So I said, fine. I told my dad to drop me over to my mom's house. When I go over there, I use the keys that I still had, and then I looked all of downstairs. No one was downstairs, so I went upstairs. As soon as I got upstairs, I heard moaning. So I did what anybody would do. I immediately got suspicious and pulled out my phone to start recording. I slowly made it over to my mom's room and opened the door. And there it was, like for part four. Part four on how I caught my mom sleeping with her sister's husband, her brother-in-law. And this is a continuation of the story time where my mom married my boyfriend. But like I said, I pulled out my phone and started recording, and I walked over to my mom's room. I opened the door, and there it was. My mom was fully naked on the bed. And my auntie's husband's belt was unbuckled, and his shirt was unbuttoned. He was on top of her kissing her, then jumped off and fell to the floor. He immediately yells, "It's not what it looks like." And I said, oh, shut up. I'm recording everything. The funny part is I wasn't even shocked. When I told him my dad was downstairs, he bolted out the room, ran to his car, and he left. I called my mom a stupid it wasn't kind words. And she was just there bawling her eyes out. I immediately sent the video to my auntie. And even though my auntie's husband said they never actually did the nasty because I stopped it before it happened, my auntie didn't care and divorced him because, like, he still tried. And my mom was left with nothing and no one except her three cats, as she deserves. Story time on how on Valentine's Day, I found out my fiance was cheating on me with my best friend and that I was actually the side fiance. Y'all ever heard of a side fiance? Yeah, me either. Okay, so boom. Me and my fiance were high school sweethearts and been together since the 11th grade. We'll call my fiance Snake. We met through my best friend, and let's call her Chloe. They were actually best friends before I met either of them. I met Chloe in high school, and one day when we were hanging out, she invited Snake. Me and Snake immediately clicked and started dating a couple months after that and been together since. Chloe was super supportive of our relationship, but they still hung out without me. At first, I had a problem with it, but they convinced me to, like, trust them and that they were best friends before me. So I did. So after we started dating, he proposed to me 2 years later. Chloe was happy and supportive, and she was going to be my maid of honor. Well, that was a big mistake. Now that we're up to speed, let's get into it. Like for part two. Part two on how I found out on Valentine's Day my fiance cheated on me with my best friend and that I was actually the side fiance. So like I said, now that we're up to speed with the background information, let's fast forward to when now me and Snake are engaged and set to tie the knot on May 2nd. We're in the month of February, and we all know Valentine's Day is on February. This may sound weird, but he actually would get Valentine's gifts for me and my best friend. And I thought nothing was wrong with it. I honestly don't know how I didn't see all these signs, but anyways, this particular Valentine's Day, my fiance was going to be out of town, so I made plans with Chloe. But in actuality, Chloe was just setting me up. She told me she rented out a hotel and that we could just Netflix and chill, drink wine, eat food, and just celebrate love. I got all cute and told Chloe that I was on my way. She told me she left the door cracked open and to just come in. I forgot to say my fiance's name is Snake and best friend is Chloe. Anyways, you wouldn't believe what I walked into. My heart broke. Life for part three. Part three on how on Valentine's Day I found out my fiance was cheating on me with my best friend and that I was actually the side fiance. Anyone ever heard of a side fiance? Yeah, me either. So anyways, like I said, my best friend Hoey Chloe told me to just walk into the hotel room. So I did. And of course, I started hearing moaning. I seen rose petals leading up to the bed, and when I looked up, I see my fiance literally pounding my best friend with her legs wide open. My jaws dropped. My fiance jumped. I screamed, and my fiance Snake is just frozen like he just seen a ghost. Y'all wouldn't believe what happened next. Chloe gets up and puts a robe on and says it's time to tell her. I'm in tears and my fiance just says, I'm sorry, baby. Then Chloe drops the ball and says that they've been sleeping with each other for the past year and that they're getting married. And then she shows me her engagement ring. My heart shattered to a million pieces. Life for part four. Part four on how on Valentine's Day, I found out my fiance was cheating on me with my best friend and that I was actually the side fiance. Yes, a side fiance. So like I said, my best friend Hoey Chloe said that they've been sleeping together for 1 year and that they're going to get married. My fiance Snake said it kind of just happened and that he didn't want to tell me this way. I cried saying, how could the both of you do this to me? The betrayal of two people you love doing this to you was just deep. What's so messed up is that when I told her I was on my way, that's when she decided to sleep with him so I can literally walk into it. I left and cried my eyes out. My friendship with Chloe was obviously over, and my engagement to Snake was called off. It was so embarrassing to tell my family. The marriage with Chloe and Snake didn't last long. They actually divorced 2 years later, but they did have a kid together. I received a letter from Snake basically apologizing and said how he feels shitty about the whole thing. Chloe, on the other hand, she was very cold. She actually never reached out to me. It took a while to let love back in, but after therapy and finding the love of my life, I healed and I'm doing great. Happy Valentine's Day. Story time on how I was almost kidnapped. Okay, you guys, so today's story is my own. Let's get into it. Okay, so boom. I was in the 9th grade when this happened and my brother was in the 12th. We always took a bus to the bus stop that was 5 minutes away from our house and we walked the rest of the way home. I had super strict parents, so I didn't have a cell phone. This detail comes into play later on. So on this particular day, our routine changed. My brother had to complete some community service hours, so we were going to separate. I was gonna go home and my brother was gonna go the opposite direction to the daycare that was also 5 minutes away from the bus stop. The bus dropped us off and before my brother walked away, he told me to be careful and I was like, yeah, thinking this was gonna be a regular walk home. But I was definitely wrong about that. About 3 minutes into me walking, when my brother was no longer in sight, a car slowly pulls up next to me and puts his window down. Like for part two. Part two on how I was almost kidnapped. Okay, so I'm walking home alone and my brother is no longer in sight and the streets are kind of empty. A car slowly pulls up next to me and a guy puts his window down. A man who looks like he's in his 40s yells out, "Hello, beautiful." I kept walking and ignoring him and he got louder and now he's following me in the same pace as I'm walking with his car. "Hey, what's your name?" That's what he yelled, but he said it so loud that it scared me and I started walking even faster. He drives up next to me again and leans over to the passenger seat to try to open the door and told me to get in. At this point, I'm jogging. So he parked his car and started jogging right after me. I full blown started running and guess what he did? He went back into his car and started driving to me. At this point, I'm 30 seconds away from my house and I don't wanna go there so he knows where I live. So I go to the gas station and he follows me. Like for part three. Part three on how I was almost kidnapped. So like I said, I started running and he got back into his car and I was 30 seconds away from my house, so I didn't want him to know where I lived, so I ran to the gas station and he followed me. So now I'm in the gas station acting like I'm buying something and this guy literally parked his car and walks inside and comes right up to me. He then says, "Hello, beautiful, what's your name?" I don't don't know why I answered. I just was scared. So I said my name was Victoria, which is not. It's Valerie, but I said Victoria. Then he grabs my arm and says, Victoria, you're coming home with me tonight. He starts to squeeze my arm and grips it really tight. Y'all, I was so scared. I don't even know why I didn't scream. I was just like in fear. But I'll be damned if this man was gonna take me home. He whispered in my ear to walk to the car. And at that moment, I screamed to the cashier. Like for part 4.